to India's Tahrir Square, my favorite revolution. The largely middle-class, overtly nationalist, anti-corruption protest led by Anna Hazare and a clutch of NGO activists funded by Ford Foundation, Coca-Cola, and the Lehman Brothers. That had a different trajectory. It actually capitalized on genuine popular rage against massive corporate scams like the 2G, the Commonwealth Games, the Bellari Brothers, as well as the fury of ordinary people against the daily grind and the humiliation of corruption in dealing with public sector. But Anna Hazare's movement, though it called itself a Gandhian movement, its definition of corruption came from an accountant's imagination. You know, how do you define corruption? The only way you can define corruption is if you nail that definition to an accepted legality. Whereas in India, a vast section of our population is outside the legality anyway. The slum dwellers, the rediwalas, the pavement dwellers. And this movement, though it capitalized on real anger, the law that it was advocating was highly un-Gandhian. It was a centralized, draconian agency with powers to prosecute, to investigate, and to punish.